it's me, Angie with History. I have this really cute hat that I thought you guys would like to make at home. It's that whole 50s, 60s look, the little slanted hats. They're like about this size. First thing I did was I got one of these from Walmart. It's about 40 cents. It's kind of like a thicker material than regular paper. So, and then I took a Tupperware because it. So they combined with a circle, and I traced it, and it's, I picked one that was decent size, because I'm going to fold it, because this, of course, has to be my my video, you guys already know. So I traced it out. I used, don't laugh, but I used an eyeliner pencil, because I couldn't find my chalk pencil, so I had to use this. Okay, so you go ahead and make a circle, and down through the middle of the circle, you want to go ahead and make one straight line. Leave an inch apart and make a little dot. So that way you know it's going to be the middle of your hat. That's the first step. And then second step, of course, you want to cut it out. And you can use any kind of material. Right now I'm going to use, to cover it, probably this one. It's like a silk black or either the silk pink. I haven't chosen it yet. So yeah. Go ahead and cut it. So. After you got your foam paper cut out, you just have to make sure, though, one thing is that it's exactly the size you wanted. Like, see, I made it a little bit too big, so I had to cut it out twice. So, yeah, definitely want to make sure, like, it's the size you want. Because remember, it's like a side hat. I mean, you can wear it down the middle if you want, but I like it better on the side. And your hair is, like, really cute and curly. Then you want to cut out a circle of your fabric and make sure you make a little slit down one part of the circle. Make sure it's going to fit all the way around. You want to hot glue the edges all the way around. Remember, you have your slit here, so make sure the slits meet each other somehow. And then you're going to hot glue them. So you should have this little thing, so that way you can put whatever little accessories you want on your hat coming out of it, you know? Or you want to make the little net look. You know? Or you have different kind of looks. I'm going to go with the flashier look, so I'm going to use these. And I have these really cool feathers behind me. You see the little peacock feathers? I got this at a secondhand store for only $1. Yeah, believe it or not. So, that's exactly what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to hot glue it just the way you see it, and I'll show you in 1 second. Okay, so I just finished gluing my hat. See, I'm not lying. You can see all the glues. And then I cut an extra piece out of my material. To cover up all the sloppiness, because I mean, it gets pretty sloppy. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish covering up my mess. And of course you can make it look better later. But this is for right now. Then I got one of these. And these, you know, they just go ahead and go into your hair really easy. So I'm going to use one of these. And you can either sew it on or hot glue it. Right now I'm going to hot glue it, but later on I'm going to go back and sew it. So that way it'll be easier, you know? I don't know which way. You can do it either way. You can, like, anyways you put it, it's going to go ahead and, like, it's like a comb, you know, so it's just going to go ahead and stick in your hair and it's not going to move it anywhere. So I'm going to do mine where this little line is, because I want my design to all kind of be either towards this way or this way. So I'm just going to do it, like, in the middle, so I can just comb it in. Okay. And then I'm going to start decorating it. I'm going to use this cute little shiny purple lace to go around the edges. So I'm definitely going to have to do that. Okay, so I'll be right back. Go ahead and do that and finish decorating it. Alright guys, so this is our last step. As you see, I already finished putting the purple around it. I haven't put these in yet, but I'm trying to see where I'm exactly going to put them. And then I already did this. I already hot glued it, the little clip. So I'm going to do these towards the back way, because Rolly said it's a good idea, and he should know. Okay. I'm going to try to somehow scoot these kind of in there so you can't see the stem. So make a little dot right there. As little as I can get it. If it doesn't stick in all the way, because I'm gonna put a diamond or something. You can put anything you would like. I'm gonna put a diamond because it kind of matches this whole theme. And later on, the more stuff you find, you can always add to it. And I chose blue too, so this, all I gotta do is put a clip in it and it'll hang a little bit towards your face. Put a little clip. It'll look really cute. You can just add that whenever, you don't have to glue it onto here. And then I'll put some pictures on my MySpace, of course, so you guys can see how it looks that way. Okay. I just glued myself. You guys like it? I love it. I can't wait to wear it. I hope you guys loved my tutorial on one of your 50s, 60s hats that you can actually make at home for under $5. Like I said, most of the stuff I do get is in the creative side of Walmart, and everything's usually some crafts and stuff. Usually everything's a couple change, the glue gun sticks and all that stuff. And the little foamy paper that is only 40 cents. And then you don't have to use these kind of feathers. They have feather bags there too, so whatever you would like. I'm sorry for the noise, I was really farted. Yeah, he did. He's not doing the video for me. It's okay, babe. So anyways, I hope you guys love my hat. Look at my MySpace, fashion history. Okay. I'm so sorry for laughing. This really is so funny. Thanks guys.